I don't want to be in there.
Lisa, come here.
What?
Come here.
What? Are you live? There's two.
Oh, that's so cool, man.
YouTube is not.
This.
Lisa, what?
That.
Why is this so, like, inaccurate? Like, it's delayed.
That's it's because YouTube live streaming is
very
slow.
Yeah, because, like, it's live streaming perfectly on OBS, but
no,
it's like.
It's not all live streaming.
Thank you. this to stare at my control.
What?
You have this to stare at my control. I handed it off. I didn't know what it was. They want to run a different mic off of this thing. They want to set up, like I've done it before, it just doesn't sound great. So we'll set up a room mic like here, at our room.
Oh, and then just have it.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Now apparently one of the speakers is blown.
What
are the... Do you guys know what Mr. Vannis is? Wait, what did...
Not the 7B, the 57.
Okay, we'll go again.
You think this is going to work this long?
I wish I had actual time to set up a rig. I need more time.
Yeah. This is like something that we want to do, and we have valued the quality of technology that we offer. These things are right. You've got the expertise.
We just
need to be able to, like I agree. You're going to kick it up a notch, you got any time to kick it up a notch.
Yeah, like if you want us to be better, we need time for the setup.
Yeah.
And it's like right now, we got mics, I don't know what their levels are, how it's sounding in the room. And 5 minutes is not enough time for us. And I understand that, but they get cracks all the time.
Yeah,
we get,
you're right.
We get an hour.
You need your time to check.
Thank you.
better?
Something happened.
Yeah, I feel like the light stopped. Should we go tell Alyssa?
Is this for people who are going to be in the theater?
Yeah.
So who's running this?
Roman.
Okay, because she's going to have to turn it for different things.
This is Ben, by the way.
This is our tripod. Okay. Okay.
Can you maybe get in a service to add a plug to this one?
No, it's still going. It's still going.
This is just showing what's happening.
What is OBS? This is, yeah. So, it's, if you want, you can keep that open, add this open at the same time.
Keep both of them open.
Yeah.
Can you?
Keep this open when you're moving it around.
Move it there, because we need to know that there's...
Yeah. And I'm gonna be here, so it's fine.
Wow.
I'll be here.
Huh? You still need to go into there, though. Do you and Ramon want to go into there? Into the blue room?
No.
Because, like, you'll be watching the thing anyways.
Yeah.
And just making sure that nothing goes wrong.
I have to run this. Because you're not really doing anything, you're just a being here.
What is Fiona?
Fiona's got Lisa.
Thank you.
as soon as the band is done, which is supposed to be now. Okay, but don't panic.
Okay. And we'll get as many in here as we can.
Yeah. Pardon me.
And the choir's playing. I'm just not really.
I know.
Things happen
sometimes.
Can you go in there and hear if I'm on the delay?
Probably.
It should be.
Oh,
yeah.
Is that a road? That's a nice microphone.
Test.
But this is Leo's voice.
And a little. I got it from Mr. Reed.
As long as there's enough gain on this thing.
check now.
Yeah, no, no, no. It's because I turned off
the
stream.
He stopped streaming. So go check now.
Test, 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 test. Test 1, 2, 3. Test. Test. Test 1, 2, 3.
Thank you.
Check one, check, check one, check, check. That's good? Check. Yeah, I'm hearing it. It's coming through. Yeah. One, check, check one, check, check one, check, check one, check. Check one, check, check one, check.
Check, check, check. welcome to FRC's Remembrance Day Assembly. We would like to acknowledge, with respect, the Treaty 1 land upon which Fort Richmond Collegiate and Pembina Trail School Division reside. We commit to moving forward in partnership with Indigenous communities in the spirit of collaboration and reconciliation. This is a somber event, as we are acknowledging the people who have put our lives before their own. So we ask that you respect this by not applauding after performances, remove any hats, make sure your phones are turned off and put away, and that you're respectful throughout this ceremony. Please rise for the playing of O Canada. Gathered here today to recognize the many sacrifices that have been made so that we may live in a free country. For many years before us, and even today, people are risking their lives to fight for our freedom, the freedom to embrace the many cultures that are present here today. Remembrance Day is not only about respecting the lives lost during World War I and World War II, but also the soldiers who have served in more recent conflicts. It is important to recognize that these sacrifices are also being made, and as we speak, right now there are people fighting to protect our freedom in places like Darfur and Mali. Before the official date of Remembrance Day, many people showed their respect by wearing their poppy over their heart. The poppy became the designated symbol for remembrance because of its affiliation with the First World War. It was brought to people's attention in Lieutenant Colonel John McCrae's poem in Flanders Fields. The opening lines of the poem refers to the many poppies that sprouted on the land of the soldiers' graves in Flanders, which is a part of Belgium. In Ottawa, the use of the poppy is further adapted. Every year, Canadians have the opportunity to leave their poppy on the tomb of the unknown soldier, as a symbol of absolute respect. At the end of the ceremony, you'll have the opportunity to place your poppy on one of the black wreaths we have here. Something that we need to keep top of mind is that Remembrance Day is more than just a day to honor and respect our soldiers. It is a day that should be used to show gratitude for all their sacrifices and for fighting for our freedom. It is, after all, their sacrifices that helped create the Canada we all live in today, where we have the freedom of religion, freedom of speech, and acceptance from all people around the world. In today's ceremony, you'll be able to experience the different ways we've decided to pay honor. Diversity is abundant in our community, and in today's ceremony, you will see this represented in different performances. You will hear the band play a piece about letters sent by soldiers at war to their loved ones, the voices of the choir representing haunting emotions of loss, an African drumming act, and poems written by our own students. We hope that you leave the ceremony with a deeper appreciation for the sacrifices that were made to help us become the country we are today.
By Peter Meakin is a musical representation of all the many emotions felt by soldiers and the families during times at war. The piece has three movements, each of which will be preceded by the reading of an actual letter from a soldier, setting the scene for the music you will be hearing in each movement. This is Letters for Home.
Gunner Wilfred Cope to Ethel Cope. Tuesday, November 14th, 1916. My darling Ethel, I hope you have received my birthday present, but in case you haven't, here's again wishing you many, many happy returns of your birthday. It is the first of your birthdays that we have been apart since you were sweet 17 that I can remember. I hope it will be the last. Heaven send that by your next birthday, or mine, come to that, this terrible war will be over, and that we may both be spared and united on each of our birthdays and those of our dear little children and for many years to come. It causes me many regrets and much sorrow when I remember that my selfishness has more than once caused you unhappiness, and sincerely hope that my future conduct will make you realize that notwithstanding my shortcomings, I do love you with all my heart and realize that I have one of the best wives in the world. I can now quite understand the late Lord Kitchener's preference for bachelors as soldiers. He must have realized, although a bachelor himself, that it is not the coward's fear of death, but the fear that by death many a good soldier may thus be prevented from rejoining the wife and family he loves so much. I have just that very feeling myself at times when the shells are dropping all around us and the air is whistling with them. Good night, my darling. Longing and hoping for a letter from you tomorrow.
Corporal Robert Platt, served with 2nd Royal Irish Rifles, written from Flanders in June 1915 to his father John. Since I last wrote to you, we were in a charge, and it was awful. We started out the night before and marched 13 miles. We arrived at the place about 1:30 in the morning, so that we were put into an old trench and told to await orders. So you can have an idea that our nerves were strung to the highest pitch. So the Germans started to rain shells into us, but then our artillery opened fire on the German trenches. The row was awful. The whole sky was just in one great blaze with bursting shells. Sharp at 3 o'clock, the order came down our lines to fix bayonets and to load our rifles, and 10 minutes later, down came the order to charge. So we rushed over the trench. But a good few of our boys fell on the parapet as the Germans had their machine guns trained on us. But on we went, and as one fell, another took his place. We arrived at the German trench, and when it came to the steel, they could not match us. And I am proud to say that I put out a few with the bayonet myself. Although one does not think of it at the time, one does think of it after the excitement is over. We took over 200 prisoners and a couple of machine guns. I sent home a German sword. But we were not satisfied with only one trench. We went on and took 2 more lines of them. They shelled us the whole day after we took them, and eventually they sent loads of gas, but we stuck on for what we had so dearly won. I was to be recommended for the Distinguished Conduct Medal for fetching in wounded under fire, but the officer that took my name was killed shortly afterwards, and I do not know how it will go on now, but I was promoted on the field by our own officer to corporal. I was buried 3 times by shells and had to be dug out. I got a slight bullet wound in the thigh, but I am out of hospital again and expect to go into action in a couple of days' time.
Thank you. appeared very severely wounded in his chest. On the 3rd of May, 1917, he died. He at first did very well, and he had great hopes of his recovery. He suddenly got very much worse, becoming unconscious and died shortly after. He was always talking about you and his little one, and hoping to get home to you. We all feel so sorry for you. Your husband was a great favorite with the interns and orderlies. He will be buried at Aubigny and will lie with many other brave men who, like him, have given all for others. His grave will be marked by a cross with his name. Please accept my very deep sympathy in your great trouble. With much sympathy, yours truly, Lieutenant Commander Junior Harwell.
Thank you.
1918, written by Riley Cranny. Poppies wither on the graves of soldiers who fought for us hither, living from the past's onslaught and our memories we begot. To survive but never live, we remember as to forgive, they pave the way beyond the grave. Looking to hope, the next generation will honor them and memories they evoke. Throughout the days and the nights, they fought hard for our rights. Down in trenches they used to roam, until death they called it home. November 11th, upon the same hour, was the day they gave us power. We are the ones living now, bow our heads to the silent vow. Horrors pass and horizons glow, the dead were alive not long ago, lest we forget such vital slaughter, losing the lives of sons and daughters. Still a poppy on the heart, it speaks for those who cannot start. As each year passes, people come together to remember the fallen in masses, memories of those quite heavy-hearted. We thank the soldiers who dearly departed.
Glorious and Free, a poem of remembrance. Here we are, young faces. I can see the potential of the future blooming bright miles away. The faces aren't bright or young. Their futures aren't blooming. Only the poppies are. There they lie for us, for you, for me, for Canada 2019, to be glorious and free for us, not having to stiffen our spines erected in prayer, wishing to God, to whomever, to whatever, to keep our land free in all its glory for us. Lest we forget, we'll remember thee. Those who battled, who lost their lives, their lost lives live on in legacies. We, fortunate enough to be able to wake up to the sound of birds, not bullets, to smell the flowers, not the dust clouds. We shall don our poppies on this day of acknowledgement, remembrance, lest we forget. Because standing right here, right now, I will never forget.
Good morning, everyone. We are the Peace Little Drummers. Today we are here for memories that remember all those people who sacrificed their lives. And this piece we're going to play today symbolizes peace and joy and love for our country, Canada. Thank you.
the oceans. Chaos, cacophony. The air is solid, heavy, and precious. Every breath is fire. The fire of homes, ammunition, and fellow soldiers. Scarfaces scuttle and trip, brace and yell. I run, building in ruins. Grimy walls with questionable stains. Bodies fall, unquestionable pain. I run, standing tall, I'm an easier target. Earth shakes to the right, friends dead, don't know which one. Run, attention, rifle bangs against my hip, rifle bangs against my grip. Man dead, don't know which one. Run, into the trench, dust and dirt mockingly mimic my ever-wished-for ocean.
I stand in the ocean of students, thousands of heads rise and fall to the beat of their chatter, while thousands of bones lay unsounding in the dirt of a field. Thousands of souls, potentials, and futures. Look at where we are. 2019 Canada doesn't deal with the sickly sweet smell of blood branding our bodies. They did. Those troops who lost their lives, stayed traumatized, were victimized. Memories have faded, but they are empathy for those who fought. Fought for us, fought for our futures. Fought to put us in this school. Don't take your sacrifices in vain. We must never forget.
Thank you.
school's Remembrance Day ceremony. Please place your copies on the wreaths in the hall and return to your class.